On slide 10, you will find 10 tools which are motivational tools. You can adopt these 10 tools to motivate your employees. So let me talk about the tool number one. Apply different strokes for different employees. Understand the expectations and aspirations of the employees, whether they are motivated by money, power, prestige, promotions, love or knowledge. Give them what they want and it works well as a great motivational tool. Second tool is engage employees effectively. Allow employees to participate in decision making as it enhances employee engagement. Align their efforts and energies towards organizational goals and objectives constantly. They feel that they are part and parcel of the organization and contribute their best. Empower your employees. Empowerment gives you ample time to concentrate your energies and efforts on much bigger organizational challenges. It encourages your employees to come out of their comfort zones and they think in a broader perspective to execute their tasks effectively. It improves their decision-making skills. It enables them to grow as leaders in the long run and you can keep them in the leadership pipeline. Tool number four is create collaborative mindset. Collaborative attitude is better than competitive one as the former leads to fraternity and enhanced performance while the latter results in envy and ill feelings among the employees. Collaborative mindset brings synergy within the system, thus improving organizational bottom line. Tool number five, encourage job rotation. When superiors put their subordinates in various jobs, they build cross-functional skills and empathize with others by understanding the ground realities. Additionally, they will be able to guide others as they learn executing various tasks effectively. Job rotation is indeed a leadership developmental tool as it acquaints employees with various leadership roles and responsibilities and equips them with several skills and abilities, thus developing conceptual skills which are needed for leaders at higher levels. Motivational tool number six is praise publicly. Catch people doing right things and praise them. It encourages other employees to demonstrate similar behavior. Serves as a motivational tool. Improves the performance and productivity. And you earn respect as a leader. Additionally, it changes the mindset of the people. Tool number seven, criticize privately. Call the erring employees privately to your cabin and provide sandwich feedback. Sandwich feedback starts with a positive compliment, follows with the comments for correction of behavior, and concludes with a positive compliment. It sounds good for the receiver and paves the way for better behavior. Motivational tool number eight, break the organizational barriers. The Gen Y appreciates working in flat and lean organizations and prefers collegial model of organizational behavior where there is the least gap between the superiors and the subordinates. The baby boomers and the Gen X must understand this fact and mold their leadership styles accordingly to achieve the desired organizational objectives. Tool number nine, avoid favoritism. Build trust and confidence among your employees. Treat all employees equally with respect. Remember that all employees are equal to you. Keep your personal preferences and tastes away from your professional roles and responsibilities. Final motivational tool is walk your talk. Organizations can't be run when leaders work from their air-conditioned offices. They can be run only when the leaders interact with the employees regularly and understand their pulse and make decisions accordingly. In slide 11, you can see about soft leadership. Leadership is a widely talked about subject internationally. It gives lots of energy, enthusiasm, and inspiration to many people. However, it is highly challenging to practice it. Anybody can talk about leadership from outside, but to get into the leadership role and walk the talk is easier said than done. It is essential to build Indian youth as leaders, as our nation needs leaders to ensure better quality of living and to take the future generations forward. There is an urgent need to build thought leaders in youth rather than ordinary leaders, as India being a peace-loving country that created great global leaders, including Mahatma Gandhi, who pioneered peace with an emphasis on truth and non-violence. Here are the some more details of soft leadership. This I have coined, and which is making waves all over the world. I wrote a book. I led a webinar conducted by International Leadership Association. I also led a webinar conducted by TechIC.com, and several research papers I have got them published, and they are being downloaded widely across the world. Catching up, this concept can be used both for organizations and countries to improve the bottom lines. So now I would like to talk about it from the perspective of shaping youth as global leaders. Leadership basically depends on three aspects: how you communicate with others, how you make decisions, and how you take action. When you can execute these three activities effectively, you become a successful leader. However, to evolve as a soft leader, you must communicate with an emphasis on soft skills. Make decisions by blending your head, heart, and gut. Take action, keeping the ground realities and goals in your view without compromising people orientation. There are 11 C's that constitute soft leadership. They are character, charisma, conscience, conviction, courage, communication, compassion, commitment, consistency, consideration, and finally, the 11th one is contribution. It's highly challenging for people to cultivate these 11 characteristics. However, if people possess more than 6 traits, they can get into the fold of soft leadership. Now, how to excel as a soft leader? Let us look at this aspect. When you want to excel as a soft leader, there must not be character gap, there must not be communication gap, there must not be commitment gap, and there must not be courage gap. When you stick to these 4 sutras, you can excel as a soft leader. Treat the people the way you want to be treated is the old adage. But as a soft leader, you must treat all people with respect, especially the people who are lower to you in rank file. The soft leaders possess humility and a servant attitude. Now we will talk about Janma and success. The Janma is highly ambitious but impatient. They want to touch the heights of success without emphasis on ethics and integrity. They must acquire the right means to achieve their success. Since Janma is in a hurry, they may tend to make more mistakes apart from compromising on integrity and ethics. They must learn that shortcut will cut them short forever. If they want to stand out in the race to stand out as soft leaders, they must emphasize on ethics. Although it might take a little longer time, it's worth achieving success with integrity and ethics. The fact that people often look at negative things in leaders rather than positive things. As a leader, you are always under scanner. Hence, you must walk your talk properly with an eye on your ends, with an emphasis on ethics, values, and morals. Slide number 12. According to Adam Grant, there are 3 kinds of people in the world: givers, takers, and matchers. Takers contribute less and expect more from others. In contrast, givers contribute with a great heart without expecting anything from others. Matchers fall in the middle of the road who believe in proportional returns for their contribution. They hover in between givers and takers. Givers think of what is that I can do for others. Takers think of what is in it for me. And matchers think of what is to barter and mutually beneficial to us. Soft leaders are givers, hard leaders are takers, and smart leaders are matchers. Takers are plenty who are at the bottom of the pyramid, who are very few in number. They are the people who make a difference to the world. Soft leaders belong to the top of the pyramid. They don't mind who takes credit for their efforts and achievements. They are altruist with peace, people orientation, a blend of personal humility and professional will. Their pockets may be empty, but their hearts are rich. We need such kind of leaders who can walk their talk to contribute their best to make a difference to the world. Here is the difference between takers and givers. Takers are often found to be selfish people, while givers are often found to be selfless people. Takers are often winners, while givers are winners. Takers often blame the circumstances, while givers look for opportunities to work with what they have to contribute. In the present world, takers are more, but givers are less. That's why we have more followers and less leaders. And leaders are givers. There is thrill in giving rather than taking from others. Everyone knows that we don't take away wealth when we depart from this world. We leave this world either with good reputation or with bad reputation, depending on our contribution. Remember, leaders like Mahatma Gandhi, Martin Luther King Jr., and Mother Teresa stood up for others because they were givers. They sacrificed their lives for the welfare of others. That's why they are still remembered today. Do you like to be remembered like them? If so, you must adopt soft leadership where you respect all people with your personality, attitude and behavior and make others truly special. Build soft leaders. Presently, people appreciate partnership rather than traditional command and control leadership. They believe in the concept of give respect and take respect. There is a drastic change in the mindset of the people globally due to the rapid changes in the technologies. It is essential to explore soft leadership rather than the traditional leadership styles which got outdated. Hence, build soft leaders in Indian youth who can emphasize on soft skills rather than hard skills. People orientation rather than task orientation. Transformational leadership rather than transactional leadership. Other-centered leadership rather than self-centered leadership. What is that I can do for others rather than what is in it for me to bring smiles and make a difference in the lives of others? Remember the words of Winston Churchill. We make a living by what we get. We make a life by what we give. Now in the slide 13, you can see the leadership message. Be a giver to make a difference to the world. In the slide 14, I have resources. I have three blocks meant for leadership development. You can visit them to know more insights on leadership. If you hit Google with my name, Professor M.S. Rao, my name appears first on the page. You will find around 700 articles online, which are free. When you find time, you may read my articles and you may share them with others as knowledge grows when shared. You can post your feedback on my Facebook page. My Facebook page also comes on the first page when you type my name in Google as Professor M.S. Rao. So you can like and share my Facebook page. You can post your feedback there on my Facebook page. And you can share my knowledge with others, because regularly I'll be posting articles related to knowledge, because I am very much passionate about knowledge, acquiring knowledge and disseminating knowledge. And I conduct training programs for all levels of management. As you have heard, my vision is to build 1 million new students as global leaders. I want to achieve it with the help of social media, as there is a limitation to train 1 million people physically. I want to take support of social media, which is growing very rapidly. So if you can like and share my Facebook page, whatever I post, that will go to your connections. So more and more people will get knowledge. So we can educate people more. We can build very good citizens, and we can build very good global citizens. So in the acknowledgement section, this book is going to be published very soon.